In my book, Justice, I introduce the ideas, sometimes quite abstract ideas, of famous philosophers through the use of concrete examples as a way of showing what's at stake in this or that philosophical view. For example, I take the debate about torture. Is it ever morally justified to torture a terrorist suspect to get information to prevent an impending terrorist attack? Now, some people say if that's the only way to get the information, then it's justified because the greater good is served. And this is partly, I try to show, an illustration of utilitarian moral reasoning. Jeremy Bentham said justice means seeking the greatest good for the greatest number of people. But then others object. Others say, no, torture is categorically wrong. And their argument illustrates the view of Immanuel Kant, who said consequences are not the only thing that matter in moral philosophy, but we have certain duties to respect human dignity that are categorical, regardless of the consequences. So the debate about torturing a terrorist suspect brings out the contrast between Jeremy Bentham's utilitarianism and Immanuel Kant's categorical view. Another example is the debate about same-sex marriage. Some argue we should resolve this debate by an abstract principle of liberty or equality without entering into the moral arguments about the moral status, the moral worth of gay unions and partnerships. And others disagree. Others say the case for same-sex marriage and its recognition by the state depends on showing that gay unions are morally worthy, morally legitimate forms of human bonds and family connection. That debate illustrates the debate between a liberal argument in favor of equality and non-discrimination with an argument, say, that might come from an Aristotelian who says we need to engage directly and openly with arguments about the good, arguments about virtue, arguments about what forms of human relations and family practices are worth affirming and recognizing and honoring. So this debate about same-sex marriage illustrates the way an Aristotelian perspective would insist on bringing arguments about the good and virtue into public debate rather than relying on seemingly neutral principles alone. It's the way I teach. It's the way I write about political philosophy, to use very concrete examples and dilemmas from our everyday lives to illustrate larger philosophical themes.